The promise of technology stolen and hijacked. Technology has great promise of making our lives into a paradise. Computer technology has been seen to double in power for the same price every 18 months. Services and software become eventually free. Nuclear power promised to bring electricity that would be too cheap to meter. But electricity bills have never been higher. The Green Revolution promised to bring an endless bountiful harvest, making hunger a thing of the past. But food shortages continue along with price increases. Communication innovations promised to replace much of the travel requirements, but they have increased and not only caused a strain in global oil production capacities, but also increases to air pollution and drove energy prices to all-time highs. Globalization and free trade policies promised to make world trade fairer and more just, but the leveling of the so-called playing field just ended up denying the poor players the necessary handicap point advantages they need to compete. Genetically modified seeds claim many brave new promises, but are proving to be only advantageous to the big industrial farms, and they put the entire world's food production capabilities into the greedy hands of the companies that have monopolistic aims and goals to have total control of the seed supplies. Technology's promise of a prosperous middle-class life with decent work, rising living standards, and the potential for a better future has long been the foundation of the middle-class dream. But political, legislative, and corporate choices have pushed the middle class to the brink. The military-industrial complex, along with the banking cartels, controlled by the few dozen psychopaths, our willing slave drivers, have robbed all of us blind. In the United States, between 1940 and 1970, productivity and wages increased almost 100%, both doubling in those 30 years. After that, productivity increased by 80%, largely due to technological innovations, while wages only increased by 10%. The reason for that was greedy and short-term thinking by corporations. Before that, corporations supported their workers for their entire lives. It was believed that the drivers to job production were consumers buying products their entire lives. Short-term greedy thinking took over, and workers were laid off in times of slow growth. In the name of power to the people, corporations abandoned managing pension funds, allowing the workers to manage their own. Politicians started to believe that the drivers to job production were the corporations and not the consumers, and the burden of taxation shifted from the corporations to the people. After 1980, a massive transfer of wealth from the middle class to the elite began. Laws were changed, allowing banks to set variable interest rates for mortgages, and anyone and everyone was encouraged to borrow, whether they could afford to or not. Short-term thinking banksters encouraged long-term debt, and debt finance consumption with credit cards were made too easily available. Useless consumer items with built-in obsolescence flooded the markets and addicted the gullible people with products that were often harmful to their health. People started to be faced with additional medical expenses to the delight of the growing pharmaceutical industries. Unemployment rose and wages stagnated, while cost of transportation, housing, and healthcare increased. Price of many consumer items dropped due to technological advances and because third world countries producing these cheap consumer products were robbed of their resources and the people, including children, were forced to work for slave labor wages. Many consumer items such as cars, printers, and mobile phones were made artificially low, as using these products was very expensive and profitable. Gas stations made great profits each time gas tanks were filled. Garages made great profits each time cars needed fixing and maintenance. Hotels made great profits accommodating the mobile drivers and their families. Ink cartridge producers and telephone operators made great profits each time people used their printers and mobile phones. The mostly useless consumer products that people were becoming addicted to were extravagantly packaged in extra large paper boxes. Printed words, mostly left unread, and colorful propaganda between the lines were packaged in thick newspapers and glossy magazines. They made paper producers very rich and forests very poor. Transportation providers made great profits in shipping and flying tourists to the other side of the world so that they could swim on beaches, eat in McDonald's, dance in discos, and sleep in hotels thousands of kilometers away from their homes instead of close to where they lived. The new technologies made many cheap products so inexpensive that despite money being debased and cheapened, the impoverished people could still afford to buy them. The new technologies made many foods so cheap and impoverished from nutrients that despite money being debased and cheapened, the undernourished, overweight people could still afford to eat and get fattened like pigs from them. Hyperinflation that was the result of overprinting of money in the past was kept to tolerable levels due to the low manufacturing costs made possible by technology, the exploitation of third world countries and their people, and by raping the land. New technologies were developed not only to be used in peaceful times, but also during wars. Wars forced people to sacrifice in ways never seen in peace. The rich got richer by destroying infrastructure with expensive weapons they sold and by rebuilding the infrastructure destroyed. The sweet hope that technology promised to make people's life a paradise turned sour. It was stolen from the people and hijacked by the psychopaths, the few dozen slave drivers. Instead, the technology made life for the people a living bitter hell.